Now the quarterback, Magruder, now watch him. Now he just had that great first down run from before, and he's like, I can't believe it. He knows now, with only two timeouts left, this is very bleak for his team.
If you look at the threads that lead to this, we talk about that Sacred Heart Griffin game. Then in the quarterfinal in last year's playoffs against Metamora, the Redskins led 26-14 at the half, lost their composure, and got blown out 58-26. Then we mentioned earlier the four touchdown game that Ross had against Taylorville. They were down 27-7 in that game. And then against Geneseo Darnell, Dan Rourke said that people simply did not believe that we could go into that place and win. They were down 16-0, and they did come back and win.
So you got 50 seconds left, two timeouts.
Ross cradles the ball, gets upfield, and gets Glenwood that much closer to the trophy.
That's why you give it to your best player running the football. He knew to protect that football no matter what. He wasn't going to try to be fancy. He just wanted to make sure he held on to that football.
I think most of the city of Chatham has come here today. Glenwood High School, located in Chatham, 7,000 citizens. And I do believe we've got most of them here. Glenwood is down in the Springfield area, so straight down I-55 from where we are in the Bloomington Normal area.
Tremendous Kankakee support.
Up I-55 and a little bit over, right off I-57. And they turned out for their guys as well. But unless lightning strikes one more time, and this time in their favor, the seventh time will not be the charm for the Fighting Irish.
Well, if you turn the ball over five times in the championship football game, it's very, very unusual that you'll ever win a football game. And this is what's happened right now. Unless Glenwood gives them a gift, looks like it's very bleak for McNamara.
Ross, and that will do it. Rich Zanani said, our guys remembered last year's semifinal loss to Woodstock. Most of that group is back, but you know what? Well, McNamara calls one final timeout.
Well, that's, you know, you have to credit Glenwood Redskins. They, you know, statistically, they were on the short side of the sheet most of the time, but they made the opportunities. They got the turnovers when they needed them. They made the plays offensively when they had to have them. And congratulations to them. Coach Dan Rourke there, just making sure everybody knows what they're doing. He's making everyone aware of the situation there. You know, he says, hey, no more timeouts, 32 seconds left. Protect the ball. Don't do anything fancy. And we have this game. You see the dejected McNamara sidelines there. They played hard. They gave it 100%. They kept coming back. They didn't quit. Unfortunately, penalties and turnovers were their demise today.
Bishop Mack is now out of timeouts. And so while they had the tradition, Glenwood had some resilience. They had the confidence and the belief. All the way up to this point, Dan Rourke made it clear to anybody who would listen that his team had absolutely no fear of anybody. And that confidence and that fire in that belly has resulted in a 4A state championship for the Redskins of Glenwood High School.
just great to soak in that high school emotion here in the crowd. The whole town is proud. This is when you go into the communities and you see state champion football, basketball, baseball. And this is for football. Congratulations, Glenwood.
Rich Nanani had his guys over on the sidelines, and he said, hey, you go over there and shake their hands.
That's why I enjoy high school sports. There's so much more sportsmanship in it. Not a lot of hot dogging like you see in the upper levels. I wish we could do this in college and pro. I mean, to see, instead of seeing guys fight in the middle of the field, seeing guys doing this, just walking by each other. And that's hard to do when you lose, but.
Hey, Santa can put the sled in the shed. He's got everything he wants for Christmas.
Well, the weather's not treating them right today, I'll tell you that. There's Juergens, the fine quarterback.
Rourke talked about his escapability, his elusiveness, and that's what made them pay.
You know, we had a lot of players that really stepped up today. Juergens, he stepped up today. Boyle, he played big. Pierce, I think about that interception when McNamara was threatening. Pierce made a great interception there on his back. They just had so many options to beat you offensively. It's just tough to defend them. And McNamara did a good job. But it's tough to stop an offense with that many different ways to score.
And it's a 28-21 victory for Glenwood High School over Bishop McNamara of Kankakee. Back in a moment on Fox Sports Chicago. So the 4A championship to Glenwood. Don't forget the 5A and 6A games are coming up, and they will both be dandies. Bishop McNamara receiving the second place hardware, and now they're going to change places on the podium, and the Redskins of Glenwood High School are going to come up and get the medals and the big trophy. Our Pepsi player of the game, you are looking at him, Griff Juergens, 11 of 20, 153 yards passing. He got great support from his running back Ross. He got great support both ways from his tight end Boyle.
And watch his pass. I mean, he just executes down there. He gets down there, takes a good five-step drop, plenty of time there, rifles that ball to Boyle for a touchdown.
That was the game winner to Bill Clayton.
You know, another thing that played in that final drive, with Hagler out, he couldn't put the pressure he did in the pass on Juergens, so that played a big key.
Nick Bufford, 7 receptions, 139 yards. A new 4A record for receiving yards in the title game, but you know that is going to taste like dust because it was Bufford who fumbled the ball away inside the final minute. Yes, indeed, Griff Juergens, you are number one, and your fans know it.
Oh, you feel so bad for him. Bufford. I mean, you know, something like that, you know, that's something you're going to remember for a long time, unfortunately. You know, you're trying to make a play, and things happen sometimes.
Here's the yin and the yang. Juergens, 3 touchdowns, 1 interception. Magruder, exactly even, 153 yards, but 2 touchdowns and 3 interceptions. And that thing is going to look nice in the trophy case at Glenwood High School. We wrap up the trophy presentation at Hancock Stadium. Mitch Robinson coming up next with the state champion coach Dan Rourke on Fox Sports Chicago.